El profeta Muhammad, que le paz de Allah sea con él, menciona y dice que nadie completa su fe si no ama a su hermano o su hermana lo que él ama a mí mismo. O sea, diciendo que podemos entender este hadith del profeta Muhammad, que le paz de Allah sea con él, diciendo que está hablando de los hermanos y hermanas musulmanes. Que amas algo para tu hermano o tu hermana musulmán igual que amas a ti mismo. Pero con este hadith también, ¿cuánto vemos nuestras comunidades dentro de los musulmanes, la umma, que hay gente también que no ama a otra persona que él ama a él mismo? ¿Cuánto vemos que hay comunidades que también, esa comunidad es árabe, por ejemplo, otra es de Pakistán, otros de otro país, que no, nunca quieren trabajar juntos? So, imagínense, si estamos haciendo eso en nuestra umma, o nuestras comunidades con otros musulmanes, ¿qué hay gente que está haciendo con los que no son musulmanes? Tenemos el mismo problema. ¿O cuánto vemos, aparte de seguir en nuestros pesos, de hacer esas malas cosas, ¿por qué no aprendemos de nuestra religión? ¿Qué dice el Islam? ¿Cómo podemos tratar a otra gente? ¿Cómo vivimos juntos sin problemas? Y podemos aprender mucho de la historia de la historia del Islam, de la vida del profeta Muhammad, que le paz de Allah sea con él. Y vemos que cómo podemos aprender de gente que ya pasaban o todavía están pasados en el mismo problema. Un ejemplo, a los musulmanes que viven en China o viven en Burma, o a la gente que vive en Palestina, ¿qué está pasando con ellos? ¿Qué podemos aprender de esa gente que están pasando en dificultades cada día? ¿Cómo podemos vivir juntos aprendiendo de ellos para aplicarlo en nuestra vida? Siempre decimos algo en inglés, lo voy a decir en español, que cómo trata a una persona como quieres que la gente te trate a ti, ¿no? Así vivimos. El Islam nos enseña cómo tener amor con otra gente, cómo amar a la otra gente, a cuidar a otra gente y vivir con otra gente. No solo está hablando de los musulmanes, cómo vivir con toda la humanidad. El profeta Muhammad, que le pasa a Allah sea con él, menciona y dice que a toda la humanidad, que el blanco no es mejor de un moreno, ni el moreno es mejor de un blanco, ni el árabe mejor de una persona que no es árabe, ni la persona que no es árabe mejor que la persona que es árabe, excepto en piedad y buenas acciones. O sea, diciendo que solo Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sabe de la persona que es mejor de otra persona. Pero pues necesitamos vivir juntos, diciendo que yo puedo ayudar a otra gente o yo no soy mejor que otra persona. Y este hadith, hermanos y hermanas, no es específicamente a los musulmanes, es a toda la humanidad. Pero porque no solo los musulmanes tienen una persona blanca o una persona morena o una persona árabe y otra persona que no es árabe. Es toda la humanidad. Somos diferentes naciones, somos diferentes colores, hablamos diferentes idiomas y todos somos de la misma humanidad. Pero como mencionamos, ¿qué también podemos aprender de la historia del Islam, de la vida del profeta Muhammad, que la paz de Allah sea con él? Una historia es de Bilal radiallahu anhu. Bilal radiallahu anhu era el muaddin del profeta Muhammad, que la paz de Allah sea con él. El muaddin, la persona que llama al adán, la llamada para hacer la oración. Bilal era moreno. En la misma comunidad era un árabe, se llama Abu Dhar. Abu Dhar era árabe de verdad, porque hay los árabes de verdad y hay los árabes musta'riba, son de estos días, los árabes que aprendieron a ser árabes, no son original. O sea, Abu Dhar era árabe original y era bien fuerte. Y después de una de las batallas, tenían mucho oro, tenían dinero, muchas cosas para dar a la comunidad. No sabían qué podían hacer con esas cosas, con el oro y con muchas cosas que tenían. O sea, los compañeros estaban diciendo, podemos hacer eso, podemos dar a esta gente, podemos ayudar a esta gente. Y así, cada persona estaba diciendo qué pensaba. Hasta que llegó Bilal radiallahu anhu y dijo, yo pienso, uno, dos, tres, lo que dijo. Llegó Abu Dhar y ¿qué le dijo a Bilal? Le dijo, Bilal, hasta tú mismo, hijo de Morena. ¿Me vas a decir qué necesitamos hacer con eso? ¿Qué hizo Bilal radiallahu anhu? Se fue, se enojó y se fue a decir al profeta Muhammad que le pase la sabiduría. Le dijo Abu Dhar, me dijo eso y eso. Se enojó el profeta Muhammad y le dijo a Bilal, vamos a hablar con Abu Dhar. Vamos a buscar a Abu Dhar y a hablar con él. Cuando regresaron, encontraron a Abu Dhar y le dijo el profeta Muhammad, tú le dijiste eso y eso a Bilal, radiallahu anhu. Abu Dhar, tú todavía tienes en tu corazón jahiliya. Jahiliya, o sea, diciendo que todavía no entiendes el fe completo. Todavía tienes jahiliya en frente de Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ignorancia en frente de Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ¿Qué hizo Abu Dhar? Empezó a llorar. Empezó a llorar y preguntó a Bilal radiallahu anhu que le perdone. Y le dijo a Bilal radiallahu anhu en frente de toda la gente, puso su cabeza en el piso y dijo, Bilal, pone tu pierna arriba de mi cabeza. En frente de toda la gente, para que la gente vea y entiende que no, yo no soy mejor que ti. ¿Qué hizo Bilal radiallahu anhu? Se bajó. Le dio un beso en la cabeza a Abu Dhar y le dijo, ya no tenemos problemas. Esas son las cosas, eso era un ejemplo, pero esas son las cosas como podemos aprender de nuestra fe, de la vida del profeta Muhammad, para aplicar en nuestra vida. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, as we all know, you know, there's a lot going on in this country and even around the world when it comes to hate, to hatred. You know, we see all different levels of hatred within our societies, within politics, right? Differences in religion, differences in languages, and down to the difference in skin color, unfortunately. You know, and during these times is when you see someone's true colors come out, right? You speak to people sometimes and you see what they think about what's going on, right? Their true colors show. So we have to understand, brothers and sisters, what Islam teaches us about this, about living, you know, equally among each other, what the Quran teaches us and what the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ teaches us. You know, a few examples I like to give are from our deen, you know, and they can really help us understand how wrong it is, right, to think that someone is better than another person, or how wrong it is to have hatred towards someone. The Prophet, peace be upon him, tells us, none of you will have complete faith until you love for your brother what you love for yourself. Right? Many will translate this and might say, you know, that applies to Muslims. That's a hadith from the Prophet ﷺ, and it applies to Muslims, right? Love for your Muslim brother or your Muslim sister what you love for yourself. Even if that is the case, right? Even if that is the case, how much do we see within our ummah that, you know, we have that same problem within our Muslim brothers and sisters, within our ummah, right? Within our society as Muslims. How many times have we seen that, unfortunately, you know, from different countries, people from different countries will separate from others. Brother Mujahid, you know, mentioned last week, he gave an example of, you know, because we've seen it and we've heard of it, that let's say, you know, an African American brother went to ask for, and me being half Arab, went to ask for an Arab, right, an Arab sister. And I know it's true what he mentioned because I've seen it happen, where they say, no, they're not interested. He comes to find out that they're not interested because he is African American, the skin color. And it literally comes down to that many times. So what is it that we can learn from our religion, brothers and sisters? So instead of following these mistakes, right, instead these are true things that are happening, right? Instead of following these, what can we learn to fix? What can we learn from these mistakes to fix them, to make them better? So I'll give, many of us give an example. You know, we can talk about examples going around the world when it comes to oppression or hatred, right? The oppressed brothers and sisters, the Muslim brothers and sisters in China, in Burma, right? Me being half Arabic, many times Arab, they like to mention Palestine, right? What's happening to the Palestinians there. But what can we learn from everything that's going on there? From other places, right? They've been in this state for many years. And unfortunately, so has in this country. But what can we learn from each other to make it a better world? Islam teaches us, brothers and sisters, to love one another, to care for one another, whether Muslim or not. The Prophet, peace be upon him, mentions to all of humanity, again, something Brother Mujahid mentioned last week, that a white person has no superiority over a black person has no superiority over a white, an Arab has no superiority over a non-Arab, and vice versa as well, except in piety and good deed. Except in piety and good deed means only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the truthfulness coming out of the heart of this person. So no one else can see it. Everyone can act it, for instance, but no one can see the truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that hadith, brothers and sisters, as we mentioned again, it's not specific to Muslims only, right? Because we have the white and black Muslims. We have the Arab and non-Arab Muslims. So it applies to all of humanity. To be more specific, you know, I want to give some examples from the life of the Prophet ﷺ. One story I just mentioned was a story of Bilal radiallahu anhu, which was the Mu'addin, the caller of the Adhan for the Prophet ﷺ. After one of the battles that the Muslims went through, you know, they had a lot of gold, shields, you know, things that are worth value. And the companions were talking about how to split these things, what they should do. So one of them was Abu Dharr. Abu Dharr was an Arab. Bilal radiallahu anhu was of dark skin. So everyone was giving their opinion, and then Bilal radiallahu anhu, just like everyone else, gave his opinion and said we should do this and this with whatever we have. Abu Dharr stood up and said, even you, Bilal, even you, the son of a black woman, is going to come and tell me what to do? What did Bilal radiallahu anhu do? Right? He left. He walked away. He was mad. He walked away. He went to the Prophet ﷺ and he told him what happened. The Prophet ﷺ was upset as well. So he took Bilal to look for Abu Dharr. When they found Abu Dharr, he confronted him and he told him, did you tell Bilal radiallahu anhu this? And he said, yes. The Prophet told Abu Dharr, you still have jahiliyyah in your heart. You have ignorance in your heart. You have not learned that we are all the same. You are not better than this person just because he is black and you are not. So it goes way back. You know, we can give examples from way back then. So what ended up happening, just to finish that story? Abu Dharr, in front of everyone, got down on the floor, put his head on the floor, and told Bilal radiallahu anhu, put your foot on my head, to show everyone who was honored and who was dishonored this day. What did Bilal radiallahu anhu do? He got down, he picked him up, and he told him, forget about it. It's done. It's done. Nothing ever happened. Right? We move on. So, just to give another example, and when we give these examples, brothers and sisters, try to really think about it. Try to really, as we say, live the moment, right? Another example I'd like to give is one day the Prophet ﷺ was walking around in Medina and he sees the companions gathered at a tree. So he goes up to them and he notices that Abdullah bin Mas'ud was hanging off the tree, was up on the tree and hanging off. So what happened, you know, to understand why he was there, was they were dates on the tree and they needed someone to go up and get these dates. So Abdullah bin Mas'ud wasn't such a big guy, right? So he was more lean and he was able to climb up the tree and get them. As he was going up the tree, you know, it was very common that they would wear what we call a izar in Arabic, it's more like a long, a sheet that they would wrap around themselves, okay? And obviously they didn't have, you know, what we might have now, you know, with Under Armour, underwear, or whatever it may be that you wear under. So they didn't have that, obviously. So when he climbed up, right, and him being up there, the other companions being down here, they saw more than they expected, right? So they started laughing. The Prophet ﷺ comes up to them and tells them, what are you laughing at? So imagine, this is when the Prophet ﷺ comes up to them and asks them, right, it becomes awkward. There's no more laughter because you have to answer that question now. And that is, imagine that applying to nowadays, right? Let's say we're laughing and our parent comes in. You stop laughing, right? Because now you have to explain to yourself what was going on. So imagine that was the Prophet ﷺ. So he asked him what's going on. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned and said, are you laughing at his legs? So they said, yes, we're laughing at his legs. Look how skinny they are. Saying, making fun of him, right? Look how skinny his legs are. He's not tough. Yeah, he's not heavy built, let's say. So the Prophet ﷺ answered and said, I swear by Allah, the legs you are laughing at are heavier than the Mount of Uhud in the eyes of Allah. Meaning what? The honor this companion, Abdullah bin Mas'ud, has with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one knows, obviously, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning if you make fun of someone, right, or think that you're better than someone, you don't know what the relationship between this person and Allah may be, right? And you cannot insult a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine that. It makes it even worse. So no one should ever think, brothers and sisters, that someone is better than another person. Whether it comes down to color, whether it comes down to faith, whether it comes down to religion, to language, or to nationality. No one is better than anyone except in piety and in good action. And as we mentioned, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's in the heart of a person. A final note I'd like to finish. This, because I mentioned, you know, I am half Arab and half Mexican. I speak about this because I hear it a lot, being half Arab. And it's a very, very common thing that I hear. Not everyone says it, obviously, but I hear it a lot. If you know of an Arab, right, a brother or sister that you may have met, right, a friend of yours, there's a common term used when speaking of African American brothers and sisters in the Arab language. And whoever's Arab may know already what I'm about to say, right? The term used, unfortunately, is they say abid. You translate the word abid to English, and it means slave. When you confront someone and tell them, that's what you just said, they say, oh, you know what I meant. Yeah, I know what you meant. You're associating this with that. That has nothing to do with that, right? We don't say that in English. We don't say that in Spanish, and I can't speak for every nationality, but I'm pretty sure not everyone says that. So, again, it may not be everyone, but if you do know of this, brothers and sisters, it's our responsibility to fix that, to change that, and to be able to change the way we live in this world. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this clear to us. We ask Allah to forgive all of us. We ask Allah to cure all of our brothers and sisters around the world. We ask Allah to make things better around the world so things can go back and we can get closer to our brothers and sisters. We ask Allah to guide us, our families, and our friends. We ask Allah to give us the opportunity, inshallah, to do Umrah and Hajj. And we ask Allah to make us of the highest level of paradise, Jannat al-Firdaws, with the prophets and the righteous. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Aqum as-salah.